How do you get to the moon if you don't have your own fleet of minions or stack of pennies to buy or build your own Saturn V? You just need to find a sheet of paper or anything foldable, really. And for those of you who've seen this trick before, stick around because I'm expanding on it. How many times do you think we have to fold a piece of paper in order to get to the moon? Of course, we are putting aside the fact that it is very difficult to fold items more than a few times. If I had a NASA hangar, steamroller, or a forklift, I would walk you through folding a football-sized piece of paper. But I don't, so you'll have to watch the Mythbusters struggle to fold their sheet 11 times. And if I had a lifetime supply of toilet paper, maybe I would show you how quickly 13 folds adds up. How is toilet paper so tall after only 13 folds? Well, every time we fold something, it doubles in height, creating exponential growth. Let's look at a standard sheet of paper that is about 0.09 millimeters thick. 15 folds, and this sheet of paper exceeds the height of me. 20 folds, and it's taller than Lady Liberty. 24 folds is higher than the world's tallest building. And by 30 folds, we are just 2 miles short of the Kármán line, where we would earn our astronaut wings. Only 2 more folds, and we are at the airlock of the International Space Station. Which seems pretty high, but at 230 miles, we are still only about 0.09% of the way to the moon. We still have over 230,000 more miles to travel. But since folding is exponential growth, we'll reach the moon in no time. Only by fold 42 does our height exceed 245,000 miles, which is further than the moon. By folding a piece of paper only 42 times, we can get to the moon. With every fold, the width of the paper decreases. How tiny would it be by the time we get to the moon? I mean, it's already pretty small to stand and climb on. Is there even enough material in one sheet to get us to the moon? What if we broke it up smaller and smaller? What if we even stacked up the atoms end to end? To solve this problem, we will have to figure out what we're looking for. We need to know the distance the piece of paper would cover if individual atoms were stacked on top of each other. We need to calculate how many atoms there are to stack. For simplicity, let's assume the paper is made of just carbon. We will also need to look up the diameter of a carbon atom. To determine how many atoms are in the piece of paper, we can weigh the paper and find out that it's about 4 grams. And we divide this weight by the weight of the atom. Unfortunately, this scale does not weigh individual atoms, so we will have to turn to the periodic table. There's a little number at the bottom, and this is the weight of a carbon atom in atomic mass units. 1 amu is about 1.6 times 10 to the negative 24 grams. So since carbon has 12 amus, its weight is about 2 times 10 to the negative 23 grams. If we divide the weight of the paper by the weight of an individual atom, we will get 2 times 10 to the 23 atoms, which is a pretty big number. Next, we will look at how wide a carbon atom is. Its radius is about 7 times 10 to the negative 11 meters. Doubling this gets us a diameter of 1.4 times 10 to the negative 10 meters. If we multiply the number of atoms in a piece of paper by the diameter of a carbon atom, we will see how far they can stretch. A single piece of paper can extend 2.8 times 10 to the 13 meters. The moon is only 3 times 10 to the 8 meters away. This means one piece of paper can go to the moon and back over 36,000 times. So could the fault in our stars actually reach the stars? Just like before, we'll divide the weight of the book by the weight of a carbon atom to get the number of atoms contained in the book. Then we'll multiply this by the diameter of one atom to get 3 times 10 to the 15 meters. Hazel and Gus won't take us to the edge of our solar system, much less the nearest star, but they will get us out past Pluto. So I have one last question. How far can a human stretch? If the average human is 70,000 grams, and we are made of about 6.71 times 10 to the 27 atoms, we would reach 5.32 times 10 to the 17 meters. This is well past the nearest star. To put this in perspective, our atoms stacked up would take more than 56 years for light to go from one end of us to the other. That's a lot of stuff packed into a single person. It kind of makes you want to go to the gym and shed a light year or two. If you want to play around with this some more and see how far the Harry Potter books can get you, or if all the people in the world could stretch out to the farthest known object, which, by the way, we can reach in about 101 folds of a piece of paper, then you can download the Excel link in the description. You choose the composition of an object and it will figure out the rest. Leave comments about anything really cool that you can figure out. We are making a video about planet hunters, and we are building version 2 of our Coke and Mentos cannon, and we will have experiments to go along with that. Another video we're working on is how to make music and play video games using fruit, vegetables, condiments, and punching bags. Hope you have fun exploring with us.